हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डिफ्रेक्शन। सो व्हाट इज डिफ्रेक्शन? सपोज यू आर मेकिंग ए साउंड इन वन रूम एंड दैट साउंड कैन पास इन द नेक्स्ट रूम, बट व्हेन यू आर स्विचिंग ऑन ए लाइट इन दैट रूम, दैट लाइट कैन पास और स्प्रेड इन द नेक्स्ट रूम। सो दिस इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ डिफ्रेक्शन। इन साउंड वेव्स diffraction occur very frequently, but in light waves diffraction cannot be seen without some specific condition. So phenomenon which occur in waves is called diffraction, and that waves can be sound waves or light waves, and the bending of light waves is called diffraction. What is that bending of light waves? That is when you are passing a light through an obstacle, the light waves that bend is called diffraction. And all types of waves, that is radio waves, sound waves, light waves, shows diffraction pattern. So now a question might arise in your mind that why diffraction is so frequently observed in sound waves like that, and why diffraction is not occurred in light waves in our day-to-day life. So the condition for diffraction to occur is lambda, that is wavelength, should be either similar or equal to d, that is the thickness of slit. Now what is this slit? Slit is that obstacle, the obstacle which you need to make the phenomenon of diffraction. But if the lambda, that is the wavelength, is very very smaller than the thickness of slit, then diffraction will not occur. Why? This is because the wavelength of light is in nanometer. But the obstacle we get while passing the light is in meter. So it is not possible to pass a light of wavelength which is in nanometer to pass through the obstacle which is in meter. That's a huge difference. But in case of sound waves, already the waves of sound can be in meter, and it can easily pass through obstacle which is in meter. That is why we cannot see diffraction of light in our day-to-day life, but diffraction in sound waves we can see in our day-to-day life. Okay, let me show you the graphical representation of the diffraction of light through obstacle. So you can see I have written the corresponding intensity distribution on the screen is known as diffraction. This one is the intensity distribution. So this is the source of light, and when you pass the source of light through a narrow slit, it falls on the screen and spreads in this manner. But this is when you pass through the narrow slit, and this narrow slit is your obstacle here. But when you pass the light through an obstacle inside of it, or any say obstacle is of big size, the shadow formed in the screen is the geometrical shadow. And in this case, shadow is formed in two parts. This is the remaining part of the screen, and the shadow is formed here. That is the geometrical shadow here and here. So here you can see when the beam of light falls on the sharp edge of the obstacle or narrow slit, and let's assume that the size of this obstacle is comparable with the wavelength of light. So there is a departure from straight line propagation, and the light bends round the corners of the obstacle or slit. So Finally, when the question comes in your exam that define diffraction of light, you can write this as the bending of light around the sharp corners of an obstacle or slit whose size is comparable with the wavelength of light and spreading into the regions of the geometrical shadow is called diffraction of light. So this is the definition of diffraction of light. And diffraction of light is divided into two classes. One is the Fraenkel diffraction and the second one is the Fraunhofer diffraction. Now this division of diffraction, that is Fraenkel and Fraunhofer, these are actually the name of some scientists, and these are also divided based on the slit and screen and mainly the spreading of light through the slit, how it spreads. So I hope this is clear to you. In the next class, we will further discuss the Fraenkel and Fraunhofer diffraction and the various topics included in Fraenkel and Fraunhofer. Thank you for watching.